Factoring tricks, difference of fourth powers. The square root of x to the fourth is going to be x squared. And when we have a difference of fourth powers, with fourth powers, we can actually use the difference of squares twice. So let's see how that affects us when we actually factor. Taking a look at our two examples. Okay, so we have a difference of fourth powers. I know that because my exponent for my a is 4. Okay, so I'm going to write down my two boxes just like I would for a difference of squares. I know that the square root of a to the fourth is a squared. And the square root of 16 is 4. I do my opposite signs. Now, this is a sum of squares, and we just talked about that as not being factorable, so that we can't do anything with. But a squared minus 4 is a difference of squares, and we can factor that one again. So I just write down my a squared plus 4. Now I put my two sets of parentheses, and square root of a squared is going to be a. Square root of 4 is 2. Put plus in one, minus in the other, and I'm done. Let's take a look at example 2. So we have a fourth power, and we have minus, so that means we have a difference of squares. Put my two sets of parentheses in. I have the square root of 81 is going to be 9. The square root of x to the fourth is x squared. 256. Well, that's one of those that you probably should have memorized. And the square root of 256 is 16. Put plus in one, minus in the other. Cannot factor a sum of squares, but I can factor a difference of squares, which is what is in our second parenthesis. So I'm going to write down my 9x squared plus 16. And now I'm going to put my two sets of parentheses. The square root of 9 is 3. Square root of x squared is x. Square root of 16 is 4. And I put plus in one, minus in the other, and I'm done.